Okay, good morning, everybody. Welcome to a special meeting of the Standing Policy Committee on Property Development, Heritage, and Downtown Development. I'm here with my council colleagues, Councillor Dobson and Councillor Allard, and our clerk, Braden, and Braden, our planner. Sorry, it's been a long week, everybody. Also, just want to acknowledge that we're meeting on Treaty 1 land in the traditional homeland of the Métis Nation. I'll call the meeting to order. Councillor Dobson?
Yes, I'd like to bring a motion forward to appoint a chair, seeing our chair is missing today.
Okay. Would that be me?
Yeah, that would be you.
Okay, thank you. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried.
I'd also like to move a leave of absence motion for Councillor Orlico.
Okay, on a personal family matter, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. Okay, we just have the one item, the appeal.
Can I introduce it?
Okay.
Good morning.
Go ahead, Andrew.
All persons who wish to speak or receive notice of the hearing body's decisions must fill out a public representation form and submit it to the clerk or the city clerk staff as soon as possible. Copies of this form can be found at the registration table at the top of the stairs just outside the West Committee Room. In accordance with the City of Winnipeg Charter and Development Procedure Bylaw, the process the committee will follow is the appellant will be heard first, followed by those in support of the appeal. Next, those registered in opposition are heard, followed by those registered for information. Finally, the appellant may return to speak in rebuttal to comments made. However, no new information is permitted. Please note that when your name is called, it is your opportunity to speak. However, you are not obligated to do so. We also have a copy of the public hearing process brochure, which is also available at the registration table. The brochure contains an overview of the process and other information pertaining to what happens before, during, and after the public hearing. As information, all public hearings are recorded and become part of the public record. If you have any questions after the public hearing has concluded, please contact the City Clerk's Department. Item 1 is an appeal against the decision of the Director of Planning, Property, and Development to reject a variance for 109 James Avenue under file DAV151958A 2017B.
Okay, thank you. Perhaps we could have the administration give us an update since our last meeting and before we call up the first delegation.
Sure. Thank you, Chair. Yes, we had, as you know, we met a few weeks ago now on this matter, and it was brought forward to this committee. We had some outstanding issues with the variances, and new information came about some changes to the variances from the applicant, and this committee set some time apart to allow us to have some analysis of what the changes were and an opportunity to discuss some of the larger pieces of the project that that go along with the variances, but not specifically related to the variances. So we've had an opportunity now to meet quite diligently with the developers, the developer and his consultants. And we feel like we've addressed some of these outstanding issues that would relate to the variances generally. And with that, we're all very pleased in the work that's been done. That we all recognize this has been a very complex this is a complex project and will certainly continue to be a complex project as it moves forward through the design and building permit stage, but we feel that we've come to a good place in terms of the variances, the heritage and design matters that were also addressed as a bit of a corollary to the variances. So so it's back here, and as I said, we're pleased with where it's at. The variances our position on the variance application. We're obviously maintaining our existing position because that's what it was. But I think with the new information that we received about the parking and some of the setbacks, we're okay with it proceeding from a public service perspective.
So what you're saying is, I mean, the report says that you're not recommending it. But what you're saying now is because of the discussions you've had, you're comfortable with it as it is, given the new information. Is that what you're saying?
That's
I just want to be clear.
That's right.
What you're
that's
saying.
Right.
Okay. Okay.
Well, questions. So if I recall, we were almost ready to move this forward with the dropping some of the parking variances. I think the only thing left on the table is like 2A and 2F. Do we still need all of the parking variances or not? Jenny, yeah. I don't know if you recall. I think you're almost ready to move a motion.
Well, they were saying they didn't need as many of the variances. I think it's more. Can you answer that? If we would proceed, would we still be permitting all these variances, or would we be making any changes? Are you recommending, according to what you discussed?
We would be satisfied from the parking, the parking accessory parking variances. We would be satisfied with the proposed amendment from, or the changes that the applicant brought forward at the last meeting.
That amendment was dropping a number of the lettered.
Do you have
pieces.
That, Andrew? Recall what exactly it was, just so we're really clear what we're voting on and what we're deciding. I agree. I recall that we were saying they only need these ones.
It was all verbal. I don't think there's anything in
it. It may not be written down.
Yeah. I thought it was written down.
We didn't proceed with the decision, so we didn't finalize the decision. We can have that conversation now as we go through the hearing, and we can figure that out when we get there, if that's okay. I think, but that's when we make the decision. The important thing is that they have all the variances that they are going to need have been requested and posted and everything else. So we'd only be taking ones away. We're not adding any, correct?
Correct.
So it's not an issue in terms of posting it or being able to proceed.
Right.
So we can figure out the specific motion when we get to that.
Yep,
okay?
That's right.
All right. Let's start. If we can have the applicant, Colin Newfield and Sasa Ratchel. Whoever wants to come on up.
We can actually make this rather quick. This is what we're
here. Yes. Okay. If you could just do the procedure, though, just take your name and address. We don't have to take a long time.
That's what you said last time as well.
I think everybody wants to go gingerbread or whatever should be doing.
I'm Sasha Radulovich, one of the architects acting or working on this project, 546-8796 Architecture.
And Colin Neufeld. With the same company, 546-8796.
Thank you. Yeah, maybe if you just want to summarize where you're at quickly.
Okay, so we worked hard. Probably administration spent more time than they wanted on this over the last 2 weeks. We made concessions on both sides, so our client feels comfortable with most of the things that we've discussed. There's a fair bit of open-ended conversation still to be had, both with the downtown design review and heritage. However, the biggest hurdles, which related to the main plaza, which related to the setbacks, which related to variances, we think have been agreed and addressed, encroachments as well. And so we're moving forward. The matter in front of you has to do only with variances.
Yes,
yes, we have been able to address 6 out of 8 variances dealing with parking. To reiterate, to make that variance, I guess, simple, it's sort of an odd requirement. The city of Winnipeg does not require parking at all, but once you provide it has to comply to certain regulations. And so it's sort of, you know, if it was mostly motorcycles, there would be no variances, but it's still cars. So, or smart cars and smaller cars and so on. So what I'm trying to say is these variances have to do with sizes of parking stalls, have to do with proximity to columns and things like that. And on a tight urban site, some of these things are restraining us to provide exact parking. But we've sort of addressed 6 out of 8 of those variances. And then if you recall last time, the other variance had to do with the elevator on the east building, and we believe we're going to work through the urban design to address issues of access and safety on the site from now on. We've moved the elevator from the 0 lot line to a 6-foot property line, and I understand why administration is not rescinding it. As a part of the larger picture or package, we understand that will that is, we're hoping that will be an approved item today.
Okay, I'm just trying to be clear, and our memories are a little fuzzy after this week of council meetings all week. We have the first one, which is the construction with no rear yard of...
Which we've changed to 6 feet, and since one thing...
So it's 6 feet instead of...
Our report still says 20.
Yeah.
So when would we... Sorry if I just... We would be changing that? I mean... It's a great...
It sounds like right now the application, what they applied for was no rear yard. Rear yard, so that's zero. So what they're suggesting is instead of zero, permit six.
Yeah, that's what our motion would say. It would be six rather than... Yeah. And that's okay because it was a bigger variance you were asking for, so it's not doesn't need to be reposted.
Oh, I see that.
Okay, so...
And we have since received the letter from the only neighbor. The site has only one neighbor, which is Sky Condos. We received a letter from the board chair in support.
And you've received a letter in support. Okay, so that's good. So then for the other set of variances, there's six there. What changes are you making to that, or are those as...
No, you're talking about the parking variances?
Yeah, all the accessory parking area, there's A to F. On there.
Yeah, the F we could not address. We've addressed all the universal accessibility stalls. We've addressed all the most of the aisles. So the first one refers to the aisle width.
Yeah.
Of 18 to 20. We've changed 50% of the aisles to 20 feet. So we've gotten closer to
you're
that.
Closer, but
we still need it.
We still need variance A.
Yeah.
Okay.
B, C, D, E we don't, and then F we did.
So you don't need any. You don't need B to E at all. We don't need to approve those.
That's right. Yeah.
But you need F.
Yes.
Okay.
You refer to eight variances.
Sorry, apologies. It was six.
Four,
yeah.
Six.
All right. Four, yeah.
There's the first. There's number one, and then there's six under number two.
So you need two of the six, A and F.
Yes. A and F, and the first one. Yeah. And we'll change it though to what you're suggesting is it would be changed to only to 6 feet instead of zero. Okay. Anything else? Any other questions? Is that?
We can talk for hours still.
We can, I'm sure. But really, that's really all that we're deciding today. You know, I know there's other issues. So, and what you said was with the other issues, just because I know it's of interest to a lot of people. You're going to be continuing to work with the Urban Design
yes,
Heritage to resolve any concerns there.
I would suggest they're detailed. The major conversations have been had. They're detailed. Decisions or detailed conversations that have to be had. The access to the pump house and the front courtyard, we've resolved that and the grading, but it's going to take probably another month before we can finalize that because of James Avenue being entirely redesigned.
Yeah.
Right? So there's all there. That might take us for a while to decide exactly on the grades, but
But that doesn't affect these decisions here today, so there's no reason to delay those.
That's right. Yeah. What this allows us to do now is proceed with the foundation permit, which has been our biggest. Task, I guess.
Okay. Great. Any questions?
Well, just back to the public service. Ms. Chair.
We could also hear, we have another delegation or two.
Okay, sure.
We
okay.
can hear them and ask questions. Is that okay?
Yeah, I'm good with that.
You're good with that? Okay, we'll call you back up if we need to.
For sure.
Okay. Okay, so also in support, Cindy Tugwell, did you wish to say anything? We're not really addressing the heritage issue today.
No, I just wanted to follow up because I know the other stuff is coming up at another time, so we're in support of this.
We'll record you in support?
Yes.
Thank you. That's great. And I have Bryce Alston.
Yes.
Same thing?
Yes, in support. I don't wish to speak.
Okay. So is there anybody else in support who wishes to speak? Seeing none. Anyone in opposition who wishes to speak? Seeing none. Anyone for information who wishes to speak? Seeing none. Councillor, did you have a question of the administration?
Well, yeah, just after having heard everything, I hear the public service stands by the original report. However, there's been new information. So the public service with the new information is willing to support the application in the way that we've heard it from the proponent?
Yes.
With the new information?
With the new information, that's correct.
Okay.
Through the chair. I just, there's something that, with respect to the setback from what was initially asked for, which is no rear yard instead of 20, to move it up to six instead of zero, which is what their site plan is proposed for that elevator building. I think to provide additional clarity of what is actually being asked for, that we would specify that the six is for the elevator, the elevator shaft, because if it's just a 6-foot setback, rear yard setback, then the presumably whole building could move right up to the over. And that's not certainly the intent of us here.
You want the wording to indicate that that's for the elevator?
I thought if we are specific to the, you know, presently there are three components that are within the setback area. One being the elevator, which was initially requested 0, and if it's we're pushed back to 6, then we could identify that specifically. The exit stair is a 2-foot setback. We identify that, and then the exit stair on the west building, identifying that.
Do you want all those things identified they're existing within the setback?
That's right. So if you look on the report, it's the yards page 4. Where it talks about the variance analysis of what specifically is within the setback area. So I think my recommendation would be that this committee specify what components within the setback that they would be willing to.
And you're saying that you're okay with those three components in that setback? The administration is.
That's correct. With that elevator setback moving from 0 to 6 feet as
zero to
as
six.
Discussed.
Okay. So and you have that wording,
absolutely.
Mr. Clerk, if that's
so
what we're looking
is
at
based on that picture. So 6 feet for the elevator. There's the 2 feet for the one set of stairs, and then the stairs on the west building would be an 8-foot, 3-inch setback.
That's correct.
According to that drawing, and that's what you're suggesting.
That's right.
Yeah,
so rather than saying 6 feet, are we just outlining what's allowed within the setback?
That's what
as it is?
Yeah, which is ultimately the understanding that it's 6 feet for
the building would have to be. So you're not really changing the zero set your rear yard in a sense. You're just saying what these setbacks are of these specific elements, or maybe I'm
missing. Yeah, that's right.
Because we're just adding. So are we still saying no rear yard? Or are we saying 6 feet? Because one of them's 8, and it's just confusing.
I would probably look.
You wouldn't say
specifically. I think what you'd be saying is you're permitting a rear yard variance for this one set of stairs at 2 feet.
Yeah.
For the other set of stairs, 8 feet 3 inches, and then for the elevator, would be 6 feet. So you're basically just spelling out the setbacks for the specific components of this development that a variance is required for. Braden's concern was that if you say 6 feet, well, then the whole, everything on the entire, like, that's approving it for the entire
building. So are we still saying no rear yard, though? Or are we taking that out?
No.
So we're taking that out, and we're just saying that those words.
Yeah.
And that would be reflecting.
No rear yard is essentially 0, right? So if you put 0 in there, 0 feet, it's the same thing. So now you're just saying, specifying the distance.
Okay, but how do we address the wording where it says, like, there's a required 20 feet, that's what the variance is. So we're putting in all those different setbacks
instead of
20 feet.
That's right.
So would it be 20 feet with the exception of...
But we're not saying the building isn't going to be 20 feet.
We're like approving 3 new setbacks.
So what are we saying for the rear yard setback? It's just not clear to me.
So I think what... I understood that while they asked for to vary for the construction of 2 new multifamily dwellings to permit no rear yard instead of 20 feet, and then with their ability to move the elevator back, because the elevator was the greatest setback, that to 6 feet, then rather than changing it to for the construction of 2 new multifamily dwellings to permit a 6-foot instead of 20-foot rear yard setback, then, which is, I think, their latest suggestion, what I would recommend is to say for the construction of 2 new multifamily dwellings, and then specifically identify what those setbacks are for the proposed elevator. At the east of the building.
With the setback of an elevator of 6 feet.
Rather than 20 feet of the exit stairs.
The part that's confusing.
The exit stairs, 2 feet setback rather than 20 foot. And with the west building, that a setback of 8'3" rather than
with the west building. So it's a different building. So it's is that in the rear yard too, though? Because it's just, are you saying 6 feet and then you have an 8 foot one? That's where I'm confused.
Because like I said, the elevator was at a zero lot line.
No, the elevator and the other stair, I'm understanding, is still the 6 and the 8. Maybe I'm just really getting tired.
Can you see the map or the drawing of it? It might help.
Maybe that'll help. Okay, so, all right, so that works to say a 6 foot setback, and then, but 8 feet for those stairs.
Do you want to recess for 5 minutes and then, just read it
out? Well, I understand the intent of it if it makes sense to everybody else. Does it make sense to you?
On a high level, we're being prescriptive in terms of which variances for which components of the application, instead of giving a blanket variance, which could end up with buildings that we don't really want to approve.
Which makes sense to me. So why don't we not worry about the wording? Let's go through the hearing. We're almost finished, and then we can sort out the wording.
Right, because we're going to hear from the applicant.
We've decided what we're trying to do.
Right.
Generally, let's just make sure we've completed that process.
Yeah.
So you're clear about what you're recommending here? You've explained. Okay. Does the applicant need to add anything? You have the opportunity.
Well, I'd like to hear from the applicant, make sure on the record they're okay with what Braden is saying.
Do you want to just come back up for a moment to clarify if you're comfortable
make sure we're not
with
breaking anything?
We just like to hear your response to what the administration's recommending.
I think the intents are aligned, and we are very happy with what we are hearing. As long as we don't have to come back, and I guess that wording will have to be wordsmith.
Well, we need to come up with a wording right now. That's why I called you back up.
Right. Okay. So
I don't know, Braden, can you repeat that?
But just wait a sec. Right, I think it's not, those aren't the issues here. Are you talking about the issues Braden is talking about the setbacks? Are you okay with that? With that part, we're not disputing.
There's a drawing that we've submitted
that
we can revise it to that can be attached perhaps to this variance that helps identify every item or.
So that's not in dispute. Right. You're comfortable with where we're going with that. And you're comfortable with us approving the variances for A and F, correct?
Yeah.
And dropping the other ones. So we're comfortable. That's actually what we're dealing with today.
Yeah, that's right.
So you're just mentioning again that there's issues with the urban design and other things that you might want to, that you're going to be working
last
through.
Last time you're not prepared to talk about it. We're fine with that.
Well, we're not.
It's just out of contact.
It's not what we're deciding today, so, and it's not resolved yet today.
We understand
that
entirely. Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, so we're just trying to be clear in our decision so we don't create any more problems. We don't want to create any problems.
Yes.
So, okay?
I think we're good.
Is that good, Matt? All right.
Yeah.
Okay. So that is the end of our delegations. Do you want to make a motion, Councillor Allard? We can clarify.
Yeah, as long as I get the language from the city planner and or the city clerk.
Okay, go ahead with
Councillor Dobson, did you want to make a motion? I'm
either
way.
Oh, sorry. Either one.
Okay, well, I guess I'll make the motion.
Do you want to start with the closing the
No, I don't, well, I mean,
and then we get
we
to
don't,
what?
We don't really have
it. Does.
We have to sort of
no, it doesn't matter. You just you have to move the report, and we're going to make a motion.
I'll do that.
That shouldn't be a problem.
Okay, so did you call for opposition information?
Yeah, I did that.
Okay.
We've heard the last,
Okay, so I move that in accordance with subsection 2473 of the Winnipeg Charter, the variance
is. You got to move right here. You got to do this first.
No. I missed.
The report of the public service be taken.
I move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried.
That the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All those opposed? All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried.
Okay, I move that in accordance with subsection 247.3 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, just read this through and then we do the changes later.
Motion
okay,
yes. After.
So I move that in accordance with subsection 2473 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan, does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway, is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to have to be affected is situated. Supporting comments, I think this has been a very challenging site. There's been many attempts to redevelop this building. There, it is extremely complex with the heritage pieces, and thrilled to see this project move forward, which is going to be a beautiful new amenity to the downtown. And okay. I think the administration and the proponent has done their work, and we've come to a place where our administration is supportive. There's clear support from the community, and including the heritage community, and so I think we're at a place where we can support this.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried.
That the appeal be allowed in part and order...
Or as amended? Is that, or not, in part with the following changes,
allowed
right?
In part... with the following amendments.
Will the appeal be allowed in part with the following amendments? Braden?
Yeah. The good clerk has recommended.
So for the first one, what's being approved? You're approving a variance for the construction of two multifamily dwellings to permit a rear yard as follows. 6 feet for the elevator, 2 feet for the exit stair, and 8 feet, 3 inches for the west building stair.
And also the 12.6 for the west building is also included.
Ooh, with the name. Know that one.
Okay. For the west building.
And the other buildings, you don't have to say anything?
Yeah. No. It's within the setback.
It's within the 20 foot?
That's right.
Oh, okay. Okay. It's 20 feet. That's why I was confused.
Yeah.
Didn't realize
yeah,
that. Okay. I'm kind of map challenged. Okay. Does that make sense?
So
are you good with that?
So moved.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried. And that's
okay.
It. The last one.
Well, and then we need parking. To do
the decision that the director.
Well, we need to do the parking.
Do the parking. Yeah.
We need to do the parking.
Oh, right.
Okay, and so the other language for the parking.
Oh,
well, so
you're approving A and F.
Yeah.
So yeah, you're so B, C, D, and E are no longer required. So those are deleted.
Yes.
A, I believe. They said 20 feet, but 20 feet it looks like is what's permitted. So I think, is that right? Like it's saying.
We still need it. We've changed half of the aisles to 20, but
there's still some that
are. Still some
yeah.
Eight. Okay. So,
so just
we
leave
still
it.
Need A and F
so
as, need it. As is.
We're going to leave it, but they're actually going to do more than they're saying. Like they're not necessarily all going to be smaller. Some of them.
So then you're basically approving A and F, deleting B through E. For the
so
parking variance.
Can I just say so moved?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. Yep. Okay. Okay. So that's what we're moving?
Yeah.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried.
So that the...
The last... Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, do we have to say order DAV?
No.
Well, I
it's amended.
Okay.
Yeah. I allowed in part as amended.
Okay.
Yeah. But you are canceling the variance order, and we're going to issue a new variance order. So if you can just state that the variance order.
Okay. So that variance. So I move that variance order, DAV 15/1958/2017B be canceled.
Correct.
Okay.
But there's a new one going to be issued, not to worry. Okay.
So is that a motion?
That's part of this, yeah. So all those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried.
Okay. That the decision of the Director of Planning, Property, and Development be concurred in part?
Yeah. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried.
That the public hearing with respect to this appeal be concluded?
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Carried.
We're done.
Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah.
Councillor Dobson, do you want to move adjournment?
No, you're having fun.
Okay, I'd like to move adjournment.
And congratulations, let's get this thing done. Yes. 17 yeah. tries.
Yeah. Thank you very much.